You can always tell when I'm pregnant because I cry all the time.
It's your mommy's recipe.
You can tell when I've had the baby because I cry all the time.
Usually when you get to the end of a pregnancy and people throw you a baby shower, you know, that doesn't happen when you have your seventh. They're more sitting around going, don't encourage her. To your dear, if you could see what I could see, I know you would believe that isn't who you are. There's more to who I knew. I needed to get out of the bed and put on a diaper. So when it's late, you had awake, too much to take. Don't shift and forget it in the
pain. Go to get labor moving, Sharon says. Why not try taking the stairs two steps at a time?
Sharon, you take the stairs two steps at a time, not in labor.
And then it started getting hard.
Come on. She's about to get into the water.
And I had a crowd of people around me, Jenny bouncing up and down on the birth ball, like having a grand old time. You're welcome. That isn't who you
are. Push, push. I need to turn over.
I am pushing with everything I've got, wishing I didn't spend most of my pregnancy on the couch watching all of the seasons of Bones so that I might be a little more fit at that moment. Sharon suggests, what if I reached in and pulled the cervix over while you deliver the head? So let's go for it. And we did.
It's the miracle of birth.
A moment of extraordinary beauty.
Oh, oh, that's disgusting. I think I have amniotic sac in my mouth.
Now, this is the seventh one. I'm figuring I got this head done. This baby's out.
One eternity later. See it all in you.
So I stand up in the tub, and with all of my might, I push, and out comes Kaitlyn, head first, diving into the tub. Sharon's comment at this moment is, she bungee jumped, because that's what it looked like to her with that cord still attached. That is the point at which I turned to my husband, and I said, vasectomy. See you dressed in white. Every wrong made right. I see a rose in bloom at the sight of you. Irreplaceable, unmistakable, incomparable, darling, it's beautiful. I see it all in you. Other than my husband, the one person who's been there through my most vulnerable and challenging moments of my life is my midwife, Sharon Schmidt. I can't say enough amazing things about this wonderful lady, and I would have never wanted to do it without you, Sharon. And I never want to do it again.